Hello, greetings, and big thanks to GIVEC for having the International Energy Agency today at the launch of the Wind Energy Coalition for COP26. It's my great pleasure to give you the key highlights from our most recent report, the Global Roadmap to Reach Net Zero by 2050. So what do we find is actually that reaching net zero by 2050 is really a very narrow path, but it's still feasible. And what we find is actually that the electricity sector is the one that has to lead the way and could actually achieve zero emission by 2040 globally. Clearly, wind and renewables in general have an incredible role to play, leading the way this decade. What we would be expecting if we want to reach this global target is that the capacity addition from solar and wind would need to quadruple over this decade, something that the industry has already done over the past decade, so should be able to reproduce these efforts over the next decade. This huge expansion of capacity addition would be needed for two reasons. On the one hand, start replacing the more carbon intensive alternative, and on the other hand, actually supplying an increasing electricity demand that is coming from the electrification of our end uses. One example here is new demand coming from cars. Electric vehicles would need to rise from 6% this year to around 60% in 2030. But it's not the only sector that will see electricity demand rising. We see really a widespread electrification throughout the economy, for example, via heat pumps and importantly from hydrogen. Of course, energy intensity and energy efficiency in general also play an important role in decarbonizing over the next decade. So let's go a bit more in depth of what does it mean this net zero by 2060, by 2050 for the wind sector. So today, as you all know, actually, coal, oil, and gas represent over 60% of electricity generation. But this has to go down very dramatically already in the next decade, while we see increasing low carbon alternatives. For example, we see nuclear increasing, we see hydrogen-based fuel starting to kick in, and a bit of fossil fuel with CCUS. But really, the big story is about a tremendous, tremendous expansion of solar and wind, with wind becoming the first fuel to generate electricity already by 2030, and maintaining, in fact, expanding this role through 2050. Clearly, for this audience, this is a huge, huge opportunity. We need to materialize these investments. However, we need to make sure that this is done very, very quickly. So speeding up permitting, finding places to build these new turbines, making sure that investment is flowing not only in advanced economies, but in the emerging world, making sure that the transmission lines are built, making sure that the flexibility investment to integrate solar and wind, making sure that we start thinking about dedicated sites for hydrogen. All this needs to happen very quickly. Certainly a lot of hope out of this conference and a lot of hope, importantly, from the wind industry as a key pillar to make the ambition of reaching globally net zero by 2050 a reality. Thank you.